Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 2 Shadows of Enhanced Edition and stuff. We're trying to do Enderman's Quest. Oh yeah, and welcome to the special 150th episode. Every 50 episodes I like to put up a huge episode. And yeah, this will be the third, obviously. But we're either going to be doing Enderman's Quest or doing some other quest if it doesn't begin.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Maybe we didn't rest enough. Maybe I'll rest another day's worth. And if nothing, then we're going to have to go back to... we'll have to do something else. And he's got another... that's something to do with his sister, that's all I know. Other than that, I'd be doing that quest blind, as I like to do. And there's another quest after this. All I know about that, it involves the Order of the Radiant Heart in some manner and takes place 10 days after the quest that I'm trying to start. And those are his two quests. Someone hiding back there? Oh.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Anyone around? Any people? Messengers? Souvenirs? Party tricks?
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Look at that. Who are you? Oh, he's a peasant. He's an angry peasant, probably one of the ones we hurt, or he saw us accidentally kill an innocent bystander on the roof as part of Corrigan's quest. So.
Stand back for justice!
How's that? Alright, so we're sleeping. Once. Twice. Three times a lady. It's another 24 hours. Anyone?
See battle, Boo! Run, Boo! Run!
This isn't as wonderful as I thought it would be, traveling with you.
Yeah, we're just waiting around for stuff to happen. That's not the most riveting stuff. There's the mad peasant again. The mad peasant! He's on the loose! Okay, I don't know.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Okay then. I don't know what to do. Other than do something else. I'm hitting Q, but it's journal. Alright, so... we could go to the Windspear Hills. Take care of ogre bandits. Do stuff in Trademeet. We'll do this other thing. I think we're going to Windspear Hills, I guess. That'll also use up some time.
Butt kicking for goodness.
Watch us go right there and it's not proper. Maybe we'll go to Trademeet, actually. Oh, look, there's Watcher's Keep. So you could probably rest after that. Windspear Hills, I'm not sure, and it's farther away. You have been waylaid. Whoops! Well, everyone in this one, unless that's. That's bark skin. So that's like a druid kind of, or a ranger kind of bandit. Who's got the silence?
Fine. Faster than Jake. Take a fast pause.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
All right, well, two of them were silenced. Hopefully it's ones that actually cast spells. Holy smite. Assuming that one. Oh no, that one would be the magic user one. Okay, never mind. I just reposition this to what I know. I'm not sure which one's silenced. They're all just bandit.
What? Your life.
More magical magic missiles. All right, we got these two left. Guys, fight them.
Feel the backhand of justice. Great. That was right.
Thank you. And thank you. We got some scrolls here. Monster summoning 2, Oracle, and minor spell deflection. As I thought, we all know. We both know. All those spells. Well, that was fun. Yeah, Yeah, we can't save in these special areas.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
That's a really small area. Okay. So we made it this far. We still need to go all the way over here. Whoops. Now there's a wild tiger, a huge spider, and a dire wolf. The wild tiger is attacking Adam, and the rest are attacking malicious soldiers. There's also a squirrel. We don't have to worry about the squirrel, do we? You can never tell these days. Alright, so the tiger's attacking Adelman. Although not facing that way. So we'll help Adelman with that.
I'll hurt you if I have to!
Oh. We should help this poor guy with the dire wolf. I don't know if she can make it to him in time. We'll try to heal him if possible.
Your life should be mine.
Nope, not possible. Grabbing a jade ring from the ground. Hello?
Good day to you.
Hold! Trademeet is not a safe area for visitors at the moment. Unless you have business, strangers, I suggest you return whence you came. Slaughtered. Well, self-defense. Unless there's more animals that my character sees than I do not. I do have business. I have been told about these animal attacks and have been asked to help. Help would be a welcome relief at this point, although I am unsure what you can do to assist us. We fight against a revolt of nature herself in this place. But if you're serious, go ahead and enter the town. Seek out the home of the high merchant, Lord Logan Coprith. He can tell you more than I. But beware, strangers. The townsfolk are suspicious of outsiders. They blame druids for their miseries and see strangers as druid servants and spies. Well, maybe it's fortunate that we did not come here with Jahira, then. I myself am reserving judgment on the point, but I will take any help that we can get. I welcome you to Trademeet, for what's worth. The Trademeet militia captain was relieved that I wished to help stop the attacks the town has suffered. She directed me to High Merchant Lord Logan Coprith. She warned that the scared townsfolk are suspicious of outsiders, especially druids. Yeah, really, I did not plan this, guys. I mean, Jahira left the group, and then I had Corgan. And his quest was rather quick. Having to do with areas we've already been in, just now with added NPCs and enemies. And, now we have Adamant.
Don't teach my hamster to suck eggs!
Well, who's standing right there? Laconia.
And the dead.
Greetings again, ma'am. The town is still under siege by the forest beasts, so I trust you'll keep a low profile. One wrong move here could be your last. Oh, here's the captain. Oh, now he just says the same exact thing. Okay. Militia wizard.
I am one of the few who are chosen.
Best watch yourself. Thievery and fraud are not prohibited in this town, and you'll get away with neither. Thanks for that.
Such menial tasks.
Eddie, citizen.
You're not from here, are you? You'd best be careful then, my lady. We've already arrested one druid for being in the wrong place at the wrong time. I'm sure you don't want to be the next one, are you? I'm not a druid.
Eddie, citizen.
I used to hunt some of the forest animals when I was younger. I wonder if that's why they're attacking us. Getting revenge and the like. Can't say.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
So before even going into the city, there's various tents. Oh, there's a genie over there called Tacky? Tacky? Another tent. A peasant and some boxes.
Is this the way you talk to everyone, or is it just the poor people?
I don't know why you're even here. You, there's nothing to buy, and no one has money to buy anything from you. Just leave us be. Oh my. Well, and then he walks off. Okay. And I will take what you have in these boxes. Thank you very much.
These pathetic skirmishes of ours aren't worth the time I spend cleaning my weapons after the battle. The Order's campaign against the Hillmasher Giants. Now, that brought the blood up.
Huh. Alright, well, I was about to remark, there's a lot of different varieties of helmets. But I think they're all standard helmets. Keep quiet and fall back into line. You served in campaigns against the giants? Aye, and a bloody campaign it was. I slew 20 of the beasts during that scorching summer. We have a lot of chances to call him arrogant. Very impressive. I can see how you might find these incidental skirmishes a bit easy. This is true. Still, I should not complain. These incidental battles are a part of life and are over so quickly that they cause only a little inconvenience. Okay, let's find them. Kaveroslava. That goes into the city also. We have Mastav and Kaveroslava and G-Deck. And Squirrel. Moose and Squirrel. Oh, the helmets. Wait a second. I was looking at different kinds of them. An anime interrupted. So they're all just regular helmets. I do like this kind the best. Where the others go? Okay. Hi.
Well met and welcome.
I greet you, strangers, on behalf of my family and in accordance with Rom tradition. I am Karoslava, the mother of this family and its heart. Rom tradition. Well, somehow I don't see she's referring to a character from Deep Space Nine. Or a Marvel Comics character. Or a Mattel or Fisher Price. I think it's Mattel. Toy robot. So what's Rom tradition? You know, it makes me looking at them, it makes me think of Romanian tradition. If you wish, I can tell you something of your place in the future. A mere 10 gold pieces, should you desire the benefit of my gift of insight, good ma'am. Well, I guess she's talking to Minsk. So Minsk says, certainly, 10 gold pieces it is. Right, Boo? As you wish. Come and sit beside me, good man, and I shall take a hold of your hand. Close your eyes and let Kaveroslava feel your aura. Kaveroslava. Sounds like something disgusting that could happen to somebody. My god. I have Kaveroslava. Your future is unclear, Ranger. You're a gentle man with a will of iron. a goddess fondly looks down upon you. Continue your fight against evil. It shall serve you well. Well, Mintz will certainly appreciate that. Ooh, this is most goodness of news, is it not, Boo? All right, what would she say to me then?
A simple matter.
Tell my future. Hello to you, dear woman. Kavera Slava bids that you are welcome in our camp, as all are. Ten gold pieces. You are a strong woman. You have powerful blood and a destiny that shines so brightly. It is the blood of a god that flows in you. But you are not alone. There is another who calls to you for help, and I see a man, a dark man whose life has been taken from him. Okay, calling for help, I'm assuming Imowyn, and dark man, I'm assuming that's Arrhenicus. I see another. She screams. There's a beast. A beast of terrible power. And a dark man, the exile. He smiles. Okay, who's screaming? And another dark man? Or is she back to Arrhenicus now? And if he's an exile, he's exiled from where? The Wizards of Thay or something? No more. Please forgive me, good woman. Your path has overwhelmed my limited gifts. You frighten me. I wish you good fortune. Wow. It's probably a waste, but I'm kind of thinking that what if she tells all our futures?
Fine.
Stand back for justice!
60 gold. Oh, whatever.
Very well.
I cannot reveal your future. You have a powerful destiny, one which clouds my visions and frightens me. I wish you good fortune, dear man. Huh. Alright, make that 50 gold.
I am ready.
He's like, He doesn't seem happy about that.
I can dance on the head of a pin as well.
Oh, can't reveal. Okay. I have a feeling that Aerie, and especially Viconia, could have their fortunes told. These other two are companions that could come and go, but... Well, Viconia has a history with us. And Aerie, slightly shorter history, but a history nonetheless, so...
I'll do it.
Let's see if she can tell her future. Nope, alright. And finally, Viconia.
I shall follow your strength.
No. Alright. Only Minsk and Amethyst. Main player character. Alright. So, Mastav?
Run, Bo, run!
Greetings to you, good man. You are welcome amongst our family of Rom, and I offer you whatever hospitality I may. My name is Mastav. Perhaps you wish to have your fortune told by my wife, yes? This looks like she carries the pants, or she wears the pants in the family. How about G-Deck?
Good day.
Hoy there, my lord. You all are adventurers, aren't you? My name is G-Deck. How else to say that? Jidek. And I intend to be a great warrior adventurer just as soon as my parents let me leave. Oh. Are those his parents? I mean, he's ready. He's carrying a mace and everything.
Wow. Adventurer.
You look funny. Mama says you're not one of the Rom. That's right. We're Ram only. And as you try to puzzle out what that means... Just getting rid of some fog of war here. And go all around this town, it seems.
This behavior must not continue.
Whoops.
Feel the burning stare of my capstan.
I saw him, but I didn't see the dire wolf. Remember when dire wolves were kind of like a problem? And after that, it was vampiric wolves for the problem. Those are really tough.
Eddie, citizen.
Well, he said the same thing the others are. Alright, let's check out some of these tents on the way back. We don't seem to want to go in. There we go. Mistress Jean? Annalyn and Wilfred the Red.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
You'll first have to give up the socket money.
What kind of money? Greetings to you, patron. I am Mistress Jean, proprietor of this pleasure tent. If you are intent on hiring a companion and taking advantage of our services, you have come at a poor time. The genies that have come to our poor town have deprived almost everyone of coin. I have had to send most of my girls away for lack of customers. All we have left is this Wilfred fellow. He claims to have killed a dragon, which is far from likely. My girl tells me the man is built like a pair of twigs and couldn't lift a sword, never mind wield one. But he has coin, at least, unlike every other soul in this town, and he has hired my last girl, Annalyn, for his exclusive use. Sorry to disappoint. Huh. What'd she say when I... She said something when we approached. I couldn't hear her over Minsk.
A pleasure to meet a socially acceptable person such as yourself.
Sorry, my lord. My time is currently purchased up by the boar who claims to have killed a dragon over there. All he does is tell me his stupid story over and over. Okay. Let's talk to him, Wilfred the Red.
Good day.
Oh, friend. Welcome to the Tent of Pleasure, haha. I've been here for over a week myself. I can tell you that the prices are well worth it. Who are you? The name's Wilfred. Wilfred the Red of Luskin, although I am sure you've probably heard of me. Heh, adventurer extraordinaire and currently living off the excesses of my most recent plunder. It's quite a story, a tale for the ages, you might say. You wouldn't happen to be a bard, would you? Well, I'd be happy to regale you with the story anyway, if you're willing. I have a feeling we're going to regret this, but sure. Oh, I can't believe we're a half hour in already. Great. So anyway, there I was, traveling through the Troll Hills, right? I came across this large cavern, warm steam coming out of it, and the forbidding smell of brimstone and such. A dragon, I think to myself. And being Wilfred the Red, the great adventurer, I walk in and challenge the dread beast. 30 feet high he was, with a wingspan easily 3 times that, red as blood and eviler than a cockatrice in myrtle. Sorry about that. I slew the beast, naturally, after a valiant struggle. A few minor scorch marks were all I suffered for felling the beast, and its hoard was mine, more gold than you could possibly imagine. Too bad I was by myself at the time. I could only gather as much gold as I could carry. Still, it was enough to make me plenty wealthy. Plus, it was a good deed, which is my forte. That's very impressive.
Yeah, sure.
I know, isn't it? But don't take my word about this place. Talk to Mistress Jean and experience it for yourself. This is the place to be if you've got coin to spare. Well, I've gotta go. And he... going. Okay. So is Annalyn done, then? He's done with her? What's about time that moron finally left? He's giving me such a headache, and all I want to do is sleep. I'm taking some time off of this racket. Oh, it's just taking time off. Sorry, guys. No, I'm just kidding. Hello? Perhaps something will be done about these creatures soon. You would expect that the mayor, Lord Logan, would do something. My last girl, Anna Lynn, has requested a break now that that Wilfred fellow is finally gone. I can't thank you enough, by the way, so I shall have to see if I can find a replacement or two. Until those genies are gone, however, I'm not sure any of the girls will even want to come back. Oh, well, the life of a madam, hmm? Yeah, okay. Well, I guess we're done in here. It's not a quest, but they want us to get rid of these genies. Or someone to get rid of them.
Bad kicking, for goodness!
And by not a quest, I mean it just doesn't show up on a quest log for some reason. It most probably would still attempt it. Well, let's check out the tents we passed coming here. There's two or three of them. Rafi and Salahi.
Where Minsk goes, have a look evil stands aside.
I trust you find them all in satisfactory condition.
Greetings. I am Rafi, the caravan master for our group. At least I was until those damned djinn drove me out of business. Joaquin would never have allowed this to happen if she were still alive to watch over us. Those genies have moved in and swallowed all the trade routes. They mesmerize every caravan that comes in, including mine. That makes you take a poor penny for all your goods, and there's nothing Lord Logan Coprith can do. Bah! Makes my mouth swim with bile. I don't know if I'll even have enough coin to have the caravan return to Muran now. I can do little for you until them genies be gone, and then I must find supply for this town. Talk to the head of the merchant guild. Busya be her name. Is she busy? Busya? I don't know.
Greetings, good customer. A pearl to you.
Good day to you, stranger. I am Salahi, wife of Rafi, who runs the caravans here. I wish we could offer you better hospitality, but with those genies here, it's all we can do to stay alive. Huh. We are not as suspicious as the people of the town, although I think they have every right to be fearful. True that.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
There's one of them. It looks like...
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Never mind. Okay, so there's one genie. We can't get in this tent, I'm guessing. Overgrown, I guess, by the door. I don't know. The Dao Genie Tent. Trademeet Market, Southwest Gate. Okay. Well, let's check this one first. Mind you, over a half hour, we still have not entered the place. The town, it says. The city, whatever. Seem to be having trouble. Caravan merchant and driver.
Stand back!
Kalimshites, Tiberians, Waterdavians, they all make their way here eventually to arm, they do.
Okay. Between the attacks on the town by all the forest animals and these genies swallowing up all trade, there's nothing that can be done for this place. You'd best be gone. Best be gone, huh?
You'll find no better prices in arm. I guarantee it.
I'd sell you some of the goods from the caravan, but there'd be none to sell. The genies keep magicking Rafi and selling them everything we have. Until those genies are gone, we merchants can't sell anything to the town, and the town's merchants won't have anything to sell anyone. And now Rafi's broke. It's a terrible state. No need to talk to us. We're just the caravan drivers here. If you have business, you'd best talk to Raffi. He's the caravan master. We mean us. Only one of you. Now, in the past, in the first Baldur's Gate, I've gotten apprehended by the Flaming Fist just for looking. And, yeah, I didn't think it would be like that, but it is. So, it might be safe to do so here, but I'd rather not. I guess it would be Omnian soldiers apprehending us, so I'd rather not deal with that.
The bigger they are, the harder I hit!
Does he also start with his muhahaha? No. Haha, you are a strange one, mortal. You are male, are you not? I have not seen many of your kind. Huh. Again, makes me wonder, what if I talk to him?
Such menial tasks.
Would you do a little dance for me, mortal? I do so love to watch your forms writhe. It does so remind me of the djinn of home. Writhe? Sounds painful. Let's just go in, I guess.
See, battle bow! Run, bow, run!
Okay, more genies. Kanzara and Faerûn.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
I do not speak with the lesser mortal creatures, such as yourself. I be not here by choice, indeed. Okay, and the Khan?
Greetings to you, wayfarer. I am Kanzara of Kalimshan, a Dao djinn, at your service.
Dao djinn? The clans of djinn are beyond the ken of most mortals. This I understand. It is a complicated thing, wayfarer. Suffice it to say that I am a djinni of the family Dao, yes? What would Kalashite genies be doing here in Trademeet? Yes, this does beg a question, mortal, does it not? The Dao would not normally choose to make such a place our home, even temporarily, indeed. Suffice it to say that we have come on a service, hunting a criminal of some repute from Kalimshan, a rakshasa by the name of Itafir, if I'm saying that right. Rakshasa, if you have never encountered them, are devious shapeshifters and thieves. We have followed this particular prey for quite some months now, and she has eluded us at every turn. I think the only time we've come across them is in the Black Pits. Added content for the original, Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition. I don't think we've seen Rakshasa outside of there. Could be wrong, but I do not recall. We have grown tired of this chase. We know that Itafir lies hiding in this area in mortal form, and so the Dao have taken over the trade of this town. We Dao buy all that comes here, you see, and charge prices too high for the mortals to afford, and we will not relinquish it until the mortals find this Rakshasa for us. Oh jeez, they're destroying commerce and basically destroying the economy of this place. Eventually they shall run out of their food and such, and they will become desperate enough to do it. Or not. Regardless, the hunt is less taxing and far more amusing this way, don't you agree? You have monopolized the trade of this town? No, I don't think that's amusing at all. That is a very precocious statement for a mortal. What do you intend to do about it then, little one? How do you intend to dissuade us from this activity? Well, I'm not sure we can fight both of them at once. Especially unbuffed, unprepared. What would you say if I found this Rakshasa for you? I would say, mortal, that I wish the head of this Rakshasa returned to me, and once that was done, despite my amusements we have found here, the Dao would return to Kalimshan. Do you have any idea where this Rakshasa might be? If we knew where she was, we would go and collect her, yes? As a shape-changer, I am sure she hides in the form of yet another tiresome mortal, is a tactic her kind use often. It is doubtful that she and her companions actually reside in the town itself. The appetites and predilections of the Rakshasa would not keep her hidden among you for very long. But we are sure she is somewhere in the area, perhaps hidden and preying secretly upon you mortals, as the Rakshasa do. But who knows, really? She could be anywhere. Why, little mortal, do you intend to bring Itafir's head to us and end our stay in this dreary little place? We would look forward to a mortal finally ending this business. Fine, we'll see if we can get something, some more out of this. I need to collect a large amount of coin to rescue a friend. Might there be a reward if I did this task for you? Oh-ho! You are demanding a little more, aren't you? But of course, we now have plenty of treasures we could offer you, should you do this for us. So then, what do you say? Very well. I will attempt to find this Rakshasa and bring her head back to you. Ah, this is a good thing. The Dao wish you well on your hunt, then, and await eagerly the sight of Itafir's head. Dealing with the Trademeet genies. I've spoken to the djinn led by Khan Zara and agreed to bring back the head of the Rakshasa Itafir. The djinn implied that the shape-changing Rakshasa was unlikely to be in Trademeet itself, rather somewhere nearby, perhaps preying on the locals. Well, could it be one of the people we already just talked to? Because they're outside of Trademeet.
You return to the Dao, mortal, and yet I do not sense the head of the Rakshasa Itafir in your possession. Have you perhaps changed your mind?
So I was pronouncing it right. That's awesome. Okay. I just want to see your services. Ah, of course. Our goods are always available to an intrepid mortal adventurer, and it can be extremely expensive. So it would not be in our best interest to buy this stuff. It'd be getting kind of ripped off. Two potions of extra healing. 724. Well, maybe that's per. Okay. There's that laugh. I was looking for that. Hee, you will find our little Rakshashi, will you? More likely you will die, mortal. Itafir is a rook, a knight, and far too much for you. Well, you should pray for our triumph, then, because you want this head, don't you?
Bat kicking, for goodness!
All right. Ready to enter the town, then, I guess. Oh, look at that. Who is this ahead of? If these were green, I could swear it was a Medusa. Alright, so it looks like there's an outer courtyard of some kind. Wallace.
I need a swig of some strong dwarven ale.
Alas, my friend, I'm afraid I have no wares to show you. The cursed genies have taken all of Trademeet's mercantile enterprises. Perhaps another time.
Well, I guess we can start buying things if we solve their problem here. Found a fire opal ring. And an overturned bucket. just give him two. Checking for any spare stuff here. Are those his bullets here? These are his things, so once we expel him from the group, he'll get them back. Or he'll be wearing them once again. Maybe did the same thing with Corgan. Oh, there's a cow? Someone named Roddy? Mystery of Haurua. I'll leave the gold. Just in case Roddy would snitch on us. There's a horse as well. I'm gonna leave that as well. Cheap stuff, not worth the risk. There might not be a risk, but I don't know. First hand, so.
It's a fine enough day, isn't it?
You know, I used to be a ranger myself. Mm-hmm. And I know why it is that all these animals are turning us, I do. Turning on us, I do. And why would that be? It's the gods. They've turned on us all. We've done wrong here in Trademeet. We're supposed to be fair and all. Joaquin herself commanded it. Oh? But now Joaquin's gone, and everyone thinks that means they can go ahead and cheat you. Nothing here but cheats, thieves, and liars now. Yep. What does that have to do with you being a ranger? Nothing. Just wanted you to know that I was a good person, before I fell and all. But I was cheated, right here, which is worse. But it's all ending now. Before he fell and he was cheated, it's ending now. I don't think you know what you're talking about. But I do! I do! Listen to me. It won't stop with the animals. Soon the floods will come and the storms. Trademeet will be washed away. You'll see. So why is this all going to happen, do you think? Okay. I'm gonna read that again, same thing. Which would you be? Ah, you're just gonna be washed away with the rest of this blasted town. Just you watch. Humph.
I'll trade you a few words, sure enough.
Alright then. Now he's what? A farmer? Where are you guys going?
Destiny awaits.
In Baravan's name, it shall be done.
Let's all stay together, everyone. Know who your buddy is.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Well. That's the mayor's house. That's the Temple of Joaquin over here. Yeah, I didn't realize that was something I could go in. It looked like a water tower and could just, like, walk under it, maybe?
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle!
So this must be... Did you say it was a temple of who? Temple of Joaquin. I just thought Joaquin's promenade was named after a person.
Live by the sword. Live a good. Stand back for justice.
So if Joaquin is a god or goddess, actually, then this must be her supposed likeness. Look at that. Well, that's funky. Barl is up there. And Overgold Renwillen is up there. Hi.
I welcome you with outstretched hand.
Welcome to the Temple of Joaquin, supplicant. Is there something that I can do for you? I thought Joaquin was dead. How can you still worship her? Contrary to the belief of some, my boy, Joaquin is not dead. She is simply missing. The goddess of joy, Lyra, grants power to her worshippers in her stead for now. Simply missing. Some have indeed abandoned the Joaquinara faith for Lyra, Shondakul, and Timora, thinking she will never return, but this town was founded by Joaquin. We cannot abandon her. I have faith, child, and that is more than enough for most here in this town, you will see. You aren't going to turn me away because I'm a stranger? Certainly not, my boy. Joaquin is the goddess of trade. How would it look if I turned you away simply because we have never met? No, you are welcome in the home of the merchant's friend. Of the rest of the people in this frightened town, I cannot speak for them. I simply pray that things will change. They are good people, child, who have been through much. Do not think too harshly of them. I'd like to see your services. Of course. The Joaquinar are always willing to serve at a fair and honest price, of course. Alright, so if you have stuff, I would like some stuff. Okay. You don't have the good healing, like the djinnies have a few of them, two of them. Well. Yeah, I don't trust the murky potions. I think they just get you drunk or something. Potion of healing. Yeah, murky. This, it looks almost like it, but it's not murky. But it's more expensive than regular potions of healing. What if I just buy them all? 133? Looks like we'll have plenty to distribute around here. 2,660. I guess this is complete immunity, yeah. I think I'll leave that, though. May fortune seek you, child. Make sure everyone has at least four. Well, we're not going to make it for that. Actually, well, I have these. Okay. I'm going to save these in case we need disease and or poison gotten rid of as well. And then, what's his name? Barl? Hello, Barl.
The gods are unforgiving, fool.
Oh, he's not as nice as the other one. Humph, be gone. I have many duties to perform and no time to waste on one such as you. How rude. I'm glad we talked to the other guy first. We can't go down to the lower level, apparently. Okay.
See, battle bow, run! This behavior must not continue. Feel the burning stare of my hamster and change your ways.
I know, I hope we gain a lot of good reputation for solving the problem of this place. Oh, that's their market, such as it is. Mm-hmm. We'll save the mayor's house for last. I think I said that already. Viatri's Pub. It's true. They can deny it all they want. All your little parts there, but how about you?
Make way, villainy. Hero coming through.
Tavern patrons.
Stand where you're at, peasant.
I came here to listen to Alanina's music, that be all. It is one of the few pleasures we have, with the town practically under siege.
Bloke can't walk 5 feet these days without someone hitting him up.
You be a stranger, sir. I'll tell you quick that we don't be trusting strangers here any longer. There's Olma. Tavern drunk.
Top of the day to you.
There was this one time, my party and I were traveling through the elven woods down in Tethier. We got drunk with a whole group of elves. I'm guessing that time was recently. Lady Morana. Lady Morana.
Is it important, peasant?
You seem like an agreeable enough sort of man, but with these attacks on the town, one can never be sure. I would rather we did not speak. Can't help but think we have solved these people's problems, and then they will talk to us. Let's talk to V-Kang. He looks like a shady sort.
Hi, friend.
Get away from me. Please. I don't want anyone hurt. You seem rather grim. What's the problem? I wish I could talk about it. It's nothing you would understand. Just leave me be. Really? What are you, possessed or something?
Hi, friend.
I don't think I like being threatened, actually. I'm not threatening you, dear man. I just seem to attract trouble, is all. The kind of trouble you don't want to be a part of, believe you me. You think you could hurt me? Haha. You'd be surprised. But I have no intention of hurting you. Things just happen around me. They don't call me the lightning rod for nothing, huh? The lightning rod, okay. And Olma?
Hey, sexy. Do you want to take a look at me, Diddy?
We're not here for that, I'm afraid. You're probably working for those druids and have come to kill us all, haven't you? Well, I suppose if Viatri is willing to serve you, I can too. Alright, speaking of Viatri.
Never had rats. No, sorry.
Greetings to you, strangers. We don't get many travelers here, with the troubles and all. I'd be happy to offer you a room, but you'd best keep yourself as low profile as possible. I don't want any trouble here. Miranda. Got a quest? What do you know about what's going on here? About as much as you do, I'd expect. The inn's been pretty quiet since the attack started gearing up. At first, there was just some odd occurrences. A bear attack, some hungry wolves, and the like. Since then, there's been masses of creatures that have assaulted the walls, and the militia can barely keep up. People have been getting quite out of hand with their fear. There's been stories of hooded figures amongst the animals, and everyone thinks that means the druids have turned against us. Don't know why. We've always gotten on well enough with the grove. But there's no explaining that to folks, not when their lives are in danger. They saw a druid during the first attack, during the last attack, and would have stoned him to death had Lord Coprith not arrested him. He might be dead yet, if people have their way. I don't know what Lord Coprith is going to do with him, or how long he can keep up with those attacks. People will start leaving soon, I think. I'll be on my way. I'll be here if you need me again, friend. Alright, so... Miss Morella. Yeah, it sounds familiar. It's probably... a quest here. Okay, yeah, I don't know.
Don't teach my hamster to suck eggs!
A dwarf named Miranda. Miranda said you recently received a cask of ale she'd like to try. I mean, she went in with people outside. I wasn't even paying attention to the names, I guess. Right, good old Miranda. I know what she must be looking for. A nice wheat beer out of Lurin called Halfling's Help. Usually, I don't sell it by the cask, but Miranda's a good sort. I'll let you have a 50 gold pieces. Very well, here you are, innkeep. A new beer for Miranda. I have purchased a cask of Halfling's Help from Beatrice. I'll give it to Miranda when I return to the Hidden Refuge. Oh, okay. That's nearest town. Alright. That's the town with all the cats and stuff. Forgot all about that. Alright. So we have that now. Or someone does. Halfling's Help. 10 weight, okay. Someone that can carry more weight can carry that. This cask has been stamped Baldur. Inside is Halfling's Help, a light gold wheat beer from Lurin, land of the halflings in the south of Faerûn. Miranda, the dwarven wild mage for whom you retrieved the cask from Viatri's pub in Trademeet, hoped it would live up to its reputation. Connoisseurs describe Halfling's Help as a bubbly Hefeweizen that tastes like strawberries and sun-dappled meadows while packing a high alcohol punch. You can have that. You have any supplies for sale? Can't say that I do, but then I can't say that anyone does around here. If Joaquin were alive, she'd be sad to see the state the Trademeet's come to. The goddess had established Trademeet to be a place of fair business only, where shady deals were punished and such. No thieves, no liars, no fraud. Now, we not only have thieves here, but a group of caravans has camped outside of the gates and swallowed all the local business. Bribed all the caravans, I understand. No end to their gold. And they charge an arm and a leg for a loaf of bread, so the town's being starved out, you see. Joaquin would have stopped them. Now, not even Lord Coprith can do anything. I'd like to see your services, then. Well, there isn't much to be had right now, but you're welcome to some ale and a clean room. I certainly have lots of them available right now, that's for sure. Yep, he only has... any good rumors for A mug of Berduskan wine. Old Miss Hoyle lost her son during the attacks by the druid's beasts recently. She found her son with his skin eaten clean off. It was a horrible sight. Oof. Alright. So then what about back here? Can we go back down? I see nothing to even take from anything. These people are really broke. Oh. V-Kang all of a sudden says, what? No! No! A ball spawn? Here? If you're another hunter, I swear I'll cut you open. No, no! Not after all this time, I won't- Ah! Ah! Not again! What's he gonna do? Turn into a demon? He just took 78 damage. And then disappeared. What the hell? Explain this, sir, please.
Never had friends. No, sir. No.
No one can explain this? Lady Mirana, what say you?
I don't usually speak to the likes of you, but hello.
No one has anything to say about the man who is... Oh. Alanina. A bard, I presume?
You are welcome in my sight.
As a bard, I am usually welcomed wherever I travel, but this has been one place where even I am looked upon with suspicion. Arm seems to be a nation in difficulty, I would think. Hmm. Alright. Now it's raining out. We're gonna see more lightning bolts from out of nowhere. Let's work our way.
Kicking for goodness.
Keep hearing a sound. It sounds like arrows, like a bow. Loraxol guard. What kind of guard is a Loraxol guard? Oh, a guard for Loraxol Estate. Okay.
May the gods look upon you kindly.
With all the trouble we are experiencing here in the town, stranger, I doubt you'll be welcome here in the Loraxol household.
May the gods look upon you kindly.
I say the same thing. Train them well. Alright. Try going inside, see what happens. There's a guard as well. Oh, and another one.
Where Minsk
May
goes,
the gods look
evil
upon you
stands
kindly.
Aside.
May the gods look upon you kindly.
Hmm. Well, these are just guards. Oh, okay. Some of us went back here. Doesn't seem like there's anything to see, though. Oh, we can go through that door, which I did not see. Alright. We go in places? Are they trapped? You have traps on doors?
Fleet of foot and all that.
We definitely are fleet of foot. Interesting. Behind the door is a gloom-filled, musty closet with nothing of interest. Well, this is a pretty empty estate, I must say.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle. Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Lurexol is not home, and he has nothing whatsoever of interest in his place to look at, and perhaps find its way into our packs accidentally. Nothing like that, unfortunately. Fenton home. Oh, Mazzy Fenton. Oops. We need some help here. Gonna heal the guard here. Silver necklace. Oh, he's dead now, isn't he? Okay. The spider is barely injured.
Righteousness shall prevail.
Not used to hearing these different voices.
You feel the backhand of justice.
Makes it interesting though. Oh, she ran out of
a simple matter.
Bolts or fire bolts, whatever. The days grow more dangerous, and the shadows of the woodlands grow longer. Something must be done before the animals overrun us.
Eddie, citizen.
There be more than a few problems here in Trademeet, my friend. Best you be wary not to make yourself overly known, if you take my meaning. Well, if they know us better, they might come to trust us. Unless they realize we also sometimes steal their stuff. Itona here.
An excellent day for whatever you're after.
Well, she's talking to us. Hail, my good woman. Stop and speak a moment with me, if you would. My name is Itona, and I represent the Shadow Thieves here in this town. You're familiar with us, yes? I, for one, am quite familiar with you and your activities throughout Om so far. Good for you. I approach you now because we both need the other's help. Might you be interested in hearing me out, or shall I go back whence I came? I have had poor dealings with the Shadow Thieves in the past. Speak your peace and speak it quickly. As you wish. You have agreed to find the rakshasa for the Dao's Khan, correct? We know this to be true, so do not deny it. The point is, we believe we know where the rakshasa is hiding. And you may be the only one who can defeat her, we believe. We believe a lot of things. If you intend to do so, we will tell you where she is. Why would you do this? It's very simple. The genies have all the wealth in Trademeet currently, and we certainly cannot steal it from them. We want the genies gone so that the wealth is once again distributed evenly. You understand, yes? Everyone benefits this way, and we see no one else who can fight rakshasas and Trademeet at the moment, so that makes you the beneficiary of our largesse, however you say that. Fair enough, tell me then. Excellent. There's an old woman by the name of Adratha who lives in the woods near the Druid's Grove. Sounds familiar. The woman has been there for some time, selling potions and phials and such to the locals. Harmless. Lately, however, many of the people who have gone to see this woman have disappeared utterly, and we have also spotted two men who are with the woman now who were not there previously. Some of the locals who have returned say that the woman claims these are her grandsons, but we have it on record that Adratha had no relatives and said so often. Rakshasas eat the flesh of humans and are masterful shapeshifters. We believe that they have replaced the potion seller and are luring locals to their lair to consume. It seems likely. It did say that the Rakshasa is not here in the town, but somewhere nearby. Go to the witch's house then, on the way to the druid's grove, but northeast instead, and you shall find the genie's Rakshasas. And there you have it. Do this, and the shadow thieves will be pleased enough. The Shadow Thieves and Trademeet want the genies gone as well. Bad for business. Etona said that Itafir has likely replaced an old potion seller named Adratha who lives in a hut to the northeast of the Druid Grove. If I eliminate the Rakshasa, they will consider us even. Alright. She's just going, gone. The Trademeet Crypt? Oh boy. Alright. We might wait on that. Is this the... That's the crypt. Can't read the tombstones. Here lies Jed. He fell on his head. Stuff like that. Alright, I'll wait on the tombs. We'll do Mayor's house first, then tombs. Okay. So here's this estate, or Fenton home. Well, Mazzy's here. You'll say hi. Maybe we can recruit her, but I'm not gonna do so yet. There's Mazzy. We got Vara, Fenton, Pala, and Dano. Dano Fairfoot. He's not with them. He's, well, probably not related anyway.
See battle, Boo! Run, Boo! Run!
We're not picking up Mazzy yet. We have to finish Animan and whatever else.
Well met. I trust that by your being here, you've defeated the Shade Lord.
We have indeed defeated him. Did your journey home go well? The journey went well, though the thought of my slain companions weighed heavily on me. It is good to know that you've avenged their foul end. Well, not that we were companions. We've never actually had you in the group. Oh, she means... Oh, I thought she meant we're the slain. That we would be the slain companions. That's why she's glad to know we made it through safely. But she's talking about these people. Yeah, I'm not going to say about useless friends. That's really mean. Many souls were avenged when we destroyed the Shade Lord. What do you do now? At present, I am on sabbatical. I find myself missing the road, and I long again for adventure. Does your party require another sword arm? Not at this time, good halfling, though should we have need, we shall surely call on you. I do grow weary of being about the house, and I long to adventure once more. Should you require me in the future, I shall be here. Okay, good. Let's talk to Vara, Fenton.
My god protects me and watches us all.
You must be friends of Mazzy's, decked out in adventurous garb as you are. It's a pleasure to meet you. Pala, Fenton?
Oh, it's a fine day for meeting new friends.
She's an old Pala. Who are you and why are you in my house? And finally, Dano. Book him, Dano.
Weird things have been afoot lately.
Good fortune to you. I hope you're enjoying Trademeet despite our recent troubles. Excuse me, I must return to my studies. I'm learning the ancient secrets of Untharian cask making. Okay. Well, we're not going to go in these things with all these people about. So, nice to see Mazzy. We'll be back at some point to do her quests. Quest or quests, whichever it may be.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
I love the fire. Well, not the fireplace, but the flue here. The chimney. Yeah, I know words.
I never saw much of the cities from the circus. Are they all so crowded like this?
This one's not actually crowded. There's a smithy though. Oh, getting dark out.
Bat kicking, for goodness!
Yeah, I can't look at any of this stuff with for fear of them calling guards.
Well, you look like the sort who has more than two gold pieces to rub together.
I may be a blacksmith, but I have nothing in stock, and I don't want any trouble at my shop. You are strangers, and you are dangerous. Okay, bye.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
What's this place? Tiris's home, and Ali Bakar Estate. Alright, stand by, guys. I will be right back.
Young Anoman, a samurai of the West, roaming in service of God and Lord. Tell me something of your adventures.
Huh, that should be interesting.
And what shall I tell you of?
A tale of a foul beast slain, perhaps. A story of your jousts, if you wish. Very well. 2 summers passed, chosen squires of Torm were invited to a tournament in Riatavan. I traveled as the captain of our delegation, of course. Of course, Mishima says. En route, we were attacked by a wyvern. Overcome with fear, the battle plan that had been drilled into my compatriots fell apart as the first man was killed by the beast's claws. It would have been a veritable slaughter had I not kept my wits about me. What happened? Mishima asked. I jumped on its back and impaled it through the spine with my spear. Your heroic saved the day. I only did what I had to, as captain of the group. The order would have frowned heavily had I let the novice fools be diced by the creature. Okay, that was cool. Let's check out Tiris's home. Late, but whatever.
Don't teach my hamster to suck eggs!
Who's Tiris? Tiris is not home, apparently. History of
Yoshimo is willing.
We need this for the... You know, for the cause. A fire agate gem and a silver ring. What was Tiris gonna do with this stuff? I don't even know who Tiris is. Tiris doesn't need all this. We would sell this stuff and use the proceeds to buy more equipment and stuff. To help save this town, so it's justified,
good
right?
Point. Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle. Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
We only seek to know if you have truly fallen away.
Is this?
You risk injury if you come any closer, my misguided friend.
Who's that? Tell us the truth, brother. We go tired of
you
your games.
My hand.
Oops. I was killing people. And walking off. I don't even know who that was.
I have more important business than this to attend to.
That was Rasad? Sun Soul Monk says, my head. What just happened here? Base betrayal. That's what happened here. You were fighting one of your own. He was one of our own, but no longer. Who are you? We are members of the Sun Soul Order, worshippers of the Moon Maiden, Saloon. And the one you were fighting? Rasad Ibn Bashir, a great monk once. I would never have believed he could turn on the Order had I not fallen victim to his wrath. Okay, so Rasad is, as I know, a character added in the enhanced editions of Baldur's Gate 1 and now 2 as well, apparently. And, Interesting. I don't think I ever had him in the group. If I did, it was for like a few episodes and that's it. So, yeah. You could turn on the order. What led to the attack? Rasad has been absent from services these past few weeks. At first, we feared he'd fallen victim to the Dark Moon Order. Then rumors began to swirl. Interesting to say this, but it's more like, assuming or trolling? I'm not sure. It was more than rumors that led brother to raise hand to brother. Recently, a new cult has formed, led by a man named Kallus Darathan. He preaches the Dark Moon heresy that our goddess Saloon and Shar of the Dark Moon are two aspects of the same goddess. And Rasad took up the heresy. My bruises are testament to it. When he approached him and asked him to return to the temple, he attacked. An overreaction, to be sure, but I am intrigued by this heresy. Shar and Saloon, one and the same? It's an interesting notion. An interesting notion and a dangerous one. Followers of both Shar of the Shadows and the Moonbaden's Saloon flock to his false religion. Perhaps this new twin goddess offers something Shar and Saloon can't. Many will choose a comfortable lie to an unpleasant truth, but the truth remains unchanged. That might satisfy one who believes they have all the answers. It's a different story for one who has only questions. Saloon has the answers to all questions for those who are willing to hear them. Yet your friend has chosen heresy. I cannot explain what happened to Rasad. Those who are true to either Saloon or Shar oppose Darathan. The followers of the Dark Moon who have been ruthless in tracking down and killing all who believe their heresy. We gave Rasad a chance to explain himself. We'll not make that mistake again. Dark Moon. That reminds me of the Eye of the Beholder 2. The Temple of Dark Moon? Temple of... There's a Dark Moon Temple. I'm trying to remember if it is Dark Moon. Let me see. I got the wrong, just looking it up real quick. End the plot. Dark Moon. Reports of evil brewing in a temple known as Dark Moon. And then eventually it's Drandragor assembling skeletal warriors to attack Waterdeep. I'm not sure if it's the same Dark Moon, because in that game, Dark Moon is one word. And they're not mentioning Waterdeep or anything else. Or Drandragor or anything like that. Thought it might be a reference to the other game, but maybe not. You should count yourself fortunate you're still alive to make another mistake. You may be right about that. I'm not sure if I read all that, sorry guys. But we learn from our errors, as Rasad will learn from his. Okay, and in they go. Well, that was interesting. Ali Bakar Guard.
May the gods look upon you kindly.
The town is under siege by beasts, stranger. Lord Ali Bakar is not admitting people into his home while the danger lasts.
May the gods look upon you kindly.
Same. Okay. Well, what if we just go in anyway, then? We're not all going. Wait. I selected everyone.
Now, Natha.
All right.
Why are we not moving?
Stand back
together
for justice.
We're all selected.
See battle, Bo. Run, Bo, run.
In. No one is like broken up like this.
Make way, villainy. Hero coming through.
May the gods look upon you kindly.
Well, they say that, but we're just wandering around in here.
May the gods look upon you kindly.
You're right behind me, right?
Can they see this? Check what's on the table here. 20 gold, not worth the risk. 2 magical bullets, it's not even worth the risk. I'm just mousing around for question mark things. I love the little flavor text you get sometimes. Here we're behind the guard. Again, leaving it. Not enough reward and way too much risk from these guards attacking and then the townsfolk getting mad and everything else, so never mind.
Butt kicking for goodness!
Okay.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
So where did they go? They went into the Temple of Joaquin then?
Excuse me.
Oh.
I am Rasad in Bashir.
You seem familiar to me. Have we met? Of course we have, Rasad. Don't tell me you've forgotten our adventures along the Sword Coast so quickly. It was like one adventure at most.
Of course. Forgive me.
I should have recognized you, but I've much on my mind these days. Does it have anything to do with those monks I saw you beating up earlier?
How do you know of that?
I saw you. I saw you kicked your brother's arses. You fled the scene before I had a chance to greet you.
I did not want to fight my brothers, but it was necessary.
It was necessary? Also fun. It was necessary to beat the 9 hells out of your fellow monks?
I had little choice.
I can no longer trust my brothers in the Sun Soul Order. No? Why not?
A new cult has formed, based on the Dark Moon heresy. That my moon goddess, Selune, and Shao, goddess of the night, are but facets of a single deity.
Many in my sect find this idea appealing, too many for me to risk revealing my secrets to my brothers.
I seek to join this new cult.
You turn your back on Faerûn?
I would never break my vows to the Moon Maiden.
Then...
The Dark Moon heretics are led by a man calling himself Collus Darathan.
Darathan.
I believe Collus Darathan is an alias of Alagoth, the man who killed my brother Gamas.
Alargoth. Such a chicken of a different color. You can prove this?
While tracking Alargoth, I chanced upon a Dark Moon heretic.
Rather than fight, I listened to what he had to say, and the more he said about Darathan, the more I became convinced he followed Alargoth. So you have no evidence.
I know how it must sound.
Sapphire. Yet in my heart I know it to be true. I know you aren't comfortable with deception, Rasad. I just hope you aren't deceiving yourself.
Even if Darathon isn't Alagoth, the heresy clearly threatens all who serve Saluni.
Saluni. It must be destroyed. Like, why not just have him voice the next four words? What you say is true. Really? Consider this. If so many of Shara and Saluni's followers are abandoning their role sex for this heresy, perhaps the heresy has something worthy to offer.
Are you joking?
Sapphire? I'm not sure what this means. Rather see me joke about it than think on it. We don't have room in our party right now. So of course we're joking. Could you tell?
Of course I could.
Sapphire. Only a fool would try to tempt me from Saluni. Okay. Good luck with your quest, Rasad. I fear you'll need it.
Farewell.
I encountered a Sun Soul monk, Rasad, today. Perhaps I should say former Sun Soul monk, considering the state of his friendship with his fellow Saluni worshippers. Last I saw him, he was beating a handful of them down, though he was very careful not to kill them. The last thing I need is trouble from the Sun Soul, so I sent Rasad on his way. Hopefully we can find him later on. Let's see if it says anything more. It's part of my journal. Okay. It's been a while since we wrote our journal. I hope we can find him again at some point, because I do want to take on his quests. The mayor's house. So I've been to all this, except for the Trademeet crypt and the mayor's house. I do want to see what's in these blocked out sections. Then we'll go to the mayor's house. Like, can we get back here? Can I stay with the group?
Very well. Hiya. Yokata.
It didn't look like we can get there from here. It just ends. Let's see where they go.
Nothing dangerous, I would hope.
Oh, I didn't realize we can go through there.
I can dance on the head of a pin as well.
There's some people here. Oh, there's a shadow thief and someone named Kitch?
Swords, not words!
Words, not swords, at least at first.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle!
And we're all just still going...
I'll do my best.
Ados Quarth.
What is it now?
Fine.
Explain your intent and make it good.
By faith in Begora, you'll not be standing here long, methinks. Have you no ken what the attacks be all about? Have you not seen the animals as they mass and launch themselves on us? I be the one that stays in the shadows, by sure, but that be not of any use when the bloody rats themselves come hunting for you with their eyes aglow. The people here are frightened, and if you be a stranger, they'll all be the more frightened of you. Best you be on your way. Huh.
Minsk and live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Yeah, now who's this Kith? Kitch? Not Kith.
Good to see a like-minded friend to be.
Aye, he looks like a reasonable sort. With all the goods here in Trademeet squandered by the genies, perhaps you'd be interested in acquiring some goods from a less legitimate source, yes? What do you mean, squandered by the genies? Well, have you not tried to buy anything from the local merchants? You'll find them a little low on their stock, my friend. All legitimate sources of goods have been bribed by them genies to supply them alone. Loaded with gold, them genies. Wish I could get me hands on it all. I thought there was only fair business in Trademeet. May have been that way once here, but that was when Joaquin was still alive, aye? With her gone, anything's fair game in Trademeet. Alright, let me see what you have, then. Good, good. Always on the lookout for reasonable customers, I am. Depends what you mean by reasonable. It's all basic stuff. Plus one weapons. And normal weapons. A few potions. But Minsk already has quite a few of them. Kitch's goods, huh? Alright, let's see if there's anything he would like to buy then. It's all gonna be in my bags, yeah. There's only a plus one weapon. Right, what do we have? Hill Giant Strength. Only gives you 19 strength. I'll sell a bunch of these. Phantom Blade. You have that memorized. Secret word. Yeah, some of these scrolls I keep around just in case of an emergency. Although most probably wouldn't use them anyway. $13.50 for the Book of Kaza. Skull trap. Okay. Keep the rest for now. Definitely keeping haste. Now here, I'm just going to keep things that... That's his inventory. I'm going to keep things that different NPCs might need. Let me bring them into our group to do their quests, so... I will save the sell the mage robe of fire resistance. Three two-handed swords. I'll sell two. I'm gonna sell this Harp of Discord. I don't think there's any more bard characters in the game, I don't think. I think Hyrdalice is the only one. Bard, Blade, Jester, and Scald. Chainmail plus three. Full plate mail. So we have two of these full plate mails. Selling one of them. Chainmail plus three. Studded leather armor is two of them. I'll sell one. Plate mail plus one. But the other thing is full plate mail. Let's see. Full plate mail. Yeah, that's it. Alright, keeping the rest then. Okay. Alright, let's see what else we can see around here. Oops. Gentleman getting
with
lost.
All speed, comrade!
Yeah, all speed in the correct direction, please.
The bigger they are, the harder I hit.
Oh, we can't get in there. Spooky out here. What's that other noise? It sounds like a moose or something. Large animal. Not that. Well, I don't think we can see what's there. Let's see how we get through. Can I just walk through here? Oops. That sounded like a moose, I think.
Stand back for justice!
Honor and glory!
And justice. Some of us know where to go.
Such menial tasks.
Fleet of foot and all that.
Every Hansi battle bow, run, yes, bow, run!
We can't fit through there? Alright, fine.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Gotta go the long way. Oh, there's another way, another gate. All right, we'll check that out after we check out the middle here. Oh, who's that? Trissa. Who is Trissa? She's been standing here before.
Well, I certainly don't like the look of you.
You're a fool, wandering about as if nothing were happening. We'd be under siege by druids. Go ask the druid Lord Coprith, locked up. What happens to fools, aye? Oh, he's locked up? Maybe that's why they're sending animals after you, because he locked up Coprith. Lorexol Estate. Yeah. Fentanyl. Alright, so if we go out this way, we can see what might lie on the other side in the corner here. And that would be nothing much. Well, this little area here, I guess, is inaccessible. Alright, let's head for the mayor's house. You know, it's 11 p.m. He's bound to be asleep, but this is important. Wait a second. There are more people killed. No, okay. I don't think we've ever seen in this game. Owl bears. Did we talk to Wallace? I think we did. Alright, let's go to the mayor's house. And not...
A simple matter.
If that is your will...
Oh, it is. We should all stick together.
If you're sure.
I'm absolutely sure.
Trust is for the foolish and the dead.
You could trust us, Viconia. At least most of us. What's that? Beatrice Poe, okay. Oops.
Armored, but kicking for goodness!
Armored.
Please, it is so dark and late, and I am so tired. Is there no chance that we might stop and rest for a while?
Is she fatigued? Well, it's not dark in here. They have torches lit. We'll set up camp right here in the mayor's house. Aye, in a while yet. There is still some work here that we must finish. All right, but don't take long. You may think me silly, but I am just unused to traveling so late at night. You've been traveling with me for a long time. Guild Mistress Busia. Oh, we were told of her. Lord Logan's guard.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Declare yourself.
If you're here to see Lord Logan, he is within his office at the moment. He does not turn away those without appointments, so you may go in and speak to him if you wish. Okay. Guild Mistress.
You are a stranger to this town, are you not? I'm surprised you are allowed to come within the walls. You will find yourself unwelcome here.
Oh, we have been finding ourselves unwelcome here for the last 2 hours. Almost. And indeed, if you came to trade me to take advantage of our excellent markets, then you have come in vain. Between the druids and other problems, there is nothing to purchase here. Just who are you, anyway? My name is Busia, and I am the mistress of the Merchant Guild in Trademeet. Once, we promoted fair and honest trade here, but of late, my title is rather meaningless. What other problems were you referring to? There's nothing you need concern yourself with, stranger. It is enough to say that our town is in danger of collapsing. There's nothing here for you to purchase. You mean people won't sell to me? Testing her. Yeah, I know. They don't have anything. No, I mean there is nothing for you to buy. At least not from the merchants and peddlers who have traditionally sold things here in Trademeet. If you are truly desperate, you can go to the djinn that have set up their tents outside of the main gates. Their prices are exorbitant, but they own everything there is to sell. The caravans will not come because of the danger, and the few that have come only do so at the behest of the vast amounts of gold that the Tao seem to have flowing from their pockets. Is there nothing you can do about these Tao? Until these animal attacks are stopped, there is no point. If you're truly serious about helping, come and talk to me once that business is ended. Okay, I'll be on my way then. As you wish, stranger. So I'm assuming that's his office, because that's what's guarded.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Nothing in there. Oh, he stares down. Oh, Yoshimo.
What do you need? I am skilled in avoidance.
I need you to pilfer some things for me.
Hiya! The tourists love that stuff.
Potions of extra healing, hell yes. Sorry, that was the bathroom. He's got 3. He's got 2. Okay, I thought it split into 2. I don't know. Alright, so there's no question marky things. To the Trademeet prison. Oh, okay. Guess we'll check that out after the mayor.
Live by the sword! Live it! Boo says, what?
Live it. They don't usually care when you look at bookshelves. And there's 3 of them. I'm very tempted. High Merchant Logan Coprith.
Greetings once again.
I greet you with weapons ready, for I distrust your manner. We are wary of strangers, especially ones equipped as you. I am Lord Logan Coprith, High Merchant. See, more military man. My reputation is undeserved. It's a little condescending, this third option. I am Lord Indifferent. Sarcasm. Love it. Yeah, let's try to stay on his good side. My reputation is undeserved. Tell me what is wrong, and perhaps I can help you.
Trademeet has been here for generations, but now we are harassed from the strangest of sources.
It has been a very difficult time for the local merchants. The very land is against us. Animals attack, and even the foliage strangles. It began subtly, but now we suspect a dark mind behind it. Until recently, we did not know where to place blame, but now the people have found a target. The last group attack saw several figures directing the chaos. Druids, belonging to a group that has long been peaceful. The people apparently captured one. Had I not locked him up, they would have quartered him in the street. Torture him until the incidents stop. Maybe not. Has he confessed, or have the people condemned him for being a druid? That is my dilemma. He claims he is here to investigate the druids, and I believe him. Unfortunately, many of our citizens already believe him guilty. Nothing less than a public burning will satisfy an angry mob. This druid remains behind bars, as much for his own protection as anything else. Okay, so we could find him below, then.
What I would have you do is escort him to his task, or see to it yourselves, whichever you prefer.
I would seem to be collaborating if my men or I were to help him, and alone he may not make it out of town. Will you help? I will decide only when I have spoken with this man. Fair enough. You may pass and speak with him. He may also leave under the promise of your care. Good luck. Really? My journal. My journal or my quests? I don't think I read this. The Shadow Thieves and Trademeet want the genies gone as well. Bad for business. Etona said that Itafir has likely replaced an old potion seller named Adratha who lives in a hut to the northeast of Druid Grove. If I eliminate the rakshasa, will they consider us even? Yeah, I did read that. High Merchant Lord Logan Coprith says Trademeet is under siege by animal attacks. A druid named Cernd was apprehended by townsfolk. He didn't say his name. We get it from here. But Lord Logan does not believe him responsible. I am to escort him out of town, or at least talk to him. Cernd is in the town jail, which is located in the basement of the mayor's house. Okay. Anything else to say? See to it that you speak with the prisoner soon. The people are itching for a burning. All right. I'm not in dialogue mode. Okay. Books that I have. More books that I have. And more books that I have. I'm not going to steal the potion of visibility because he's like right here.
How long do you intend to crack your whip on my back? I say we stop now.
Well, we're supposed to talk to this guy. Let's talk to him first. Okay. So Airy, not fatigued, but Faconia is. What did Faconia do to become fatigued?
Ugh, my legs are just aching.
Okay.
I've never walked so much in my life.
Here she is.
Can we rest now, please?
Here?
Stand back for justice!
Well, there's Cerned.
Yoshimo is willing.
Willing but unable. Move, guys.
See battle, Bo! Run, Bo! Run!
You require my... You're right behind me, right?
Yeah, I'll take the necklace.
Very well.
Fine.
Hi-ya.
I'll talk to Cerned.
Such menial tasks.
Hello, and well met to you. I am Cerned, though my identity is surely no secret after the fuss I have caused here.
I'm just glad I pronounced his name right. You look pleasant enough. Are you friends of that charming Lord Coprith? I've made very few friends among the merchants. Coprith sent me, but I don't trust you. What exactly are you trying to do here? Coprith chose well. Caution will win the day. I will endeavor to tell you what I know, but I did not have long to gather information. I am Cerned, as I said, sent from the north to investigate why the Druid Order of this region has severed its ties with the traditional hierarchy. It is not unheard of, but the attacks have me worried. It can only lead to greater evils. These people will eventually strike out as an animal cornered. You have the Ranger Minsk in your group. Likely he will also understand the danger of balance being lost, even though I have heard he has lost his own. Oh, boy. Paying attention, Minsk? I know many druids in this region, and they would not support such actions without due cause. I suspect that there has been a change in leadership here. It is the duty of any druid to find this new leader and ascertain if this is for the best of nature. The attacks on the merchants only serve to alarm me. I might succeed alone, but I would much rather have the backing of a group, one that will also benefit from my service. Are you up for the task? Alright, so he would join our group. What's the difference between saying this and this? I will help as best I can, but I do not wish any more traveling companions. Unfortunate. We'd be stronger together, like snowflakes on the bough. If we were many, it might snap with ease. Well, let's see, I can't seem to have... physically impossible to have more than 5 people following me, I'm sorry. I will await you at the grove I have marked on your map. Do not tarry. Our task is difficult, and time is short. Oh, really? Cerned thinks the events in Trademeet might have something to do with the local druid grove losing touch with the greater hierarchy. I said I might investigate, but I didn't want him to join my party. I will meet him at the grove and discuss it there. Huh. Makes me wonder...
A simple matter.
If we can wrap up Adamant's quests and then... we're gonna wait for that. I'm not sure.
The bigger they are, the harder I hit!
Anything in these other cells? No. Okay. Well, we're done down here then.
You must
must gather your party before venturing forth. You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Stop messing around, guys. Always clowning around.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Anything else to say to the mayor, then? Anything you can do to help that druid will also help us. See to it that he succeeds. I thank you for your efforts. Well, then I welcome you for my efforts.
You are a stranger to this town, are you not? I'm surprised you are allowed to come within the walls. You will find yourself unwelcome here.
Okay. Well, that's certainly interesting. The only thing we haven't checked out is the Trademeet crypt.
Butt kicking for goodness.
Going back in the house. This must be a confusing area for them to walk around. They keep making wrong turns. Well, wrong key. The smithy. Oh yeah, this is open. It's been a while since we heard this song. Presented this way, anyway. Anyway, next episode, the Trademeet Crypt, and maybe afterwards figuring out what we're going to do with Anomen. We might just meet Cernd at the Grove and then dismiss Anomen and pick him back up. He should go back to... I think we found him at the Copper Coronet. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.